Good morning, children. Let us begin with Standard 5 English Grammar, Unit 22, Part 2 of Direct and Indirect Speech. Part 2 is the explanation of Rule 4, 5 and 6 and Exercise 2. We had learnt about the rules that we follow from changing from direct into the indirect. The first rule we saw that if the reporting verb is in the present or the future, we do not make any change in the reporting speech. Then the second rule was that when the reported verb is in the past, then the verbs in the reporting speech, if they are in the simple present, they change into the simple past. If they are in the present continuous, they change into the past continuous. If they are in the present perfect, they change into the past perfect. Then may will become might. Can will become could. And if the reported verb is in the past tense, so your simple and your reporting speech is in the simple past, so it will become past perfect. It becomes past perfect. And past continuous in your speech becomes past perfect continuous. And will become would and shall will become should. And your third rule was that any habitual fact or a universal truth, it does not change in the indirect speech though your reported verb is in the past tense, that is said. Okay, and we had done the exercise 1. So now we continue with the rule 4. What is your rule 4? Pronouns of the first person in direct speech are changed in indirect to the same person as the subject of the introductory verb. This introductory verb is your reported verb. So your reported verb here is said, right? So the subject of the introductory verb means John, right? John in the direct speech is saying, John said, I am busy. So who is this I? It is the subject of this introductory verb, that is John. So when we change it into the indirect, this first person, I, will change to he. And this he is who? John. So in indirect we say, John said that he, am is simple present, it will become simple past, was busy. Your next example is, she said, I have done my work. So she is saying, I means who is that I? Means she. So in the indirect, I will become she again. So she said that, she have will become had, done her work. My work means her work. So even the pronouns change when we change it from the direct into the indirect. And this was in the present perfect. So it changed into the past perfect, that was had done. He said, I shall do my best. So he is saying, I is who? This he. So when we make it into indirect, this I will become he. So he said that he shall, here will become should. But when we write or we say in English, we don't say should. So it will be would. Would do his best. If you write should by mistake in your exam, it is not wrong. But when we speak, we need to speak the correct English. So should won't come. We write would. Next is I said, I will not go there. So this will be in your indirect. I said that I. Why I has not changed? Because your introductory verb is already in the first person. So that will not change. I will remain I in the indirect and will become would. Not go there. The next one, I said, the girl calls me. So I said that the girl calls is in the simple present, which will change into the simple past called me. So this is your fourth rule. And your fifth rule is, if your pronouns of the second person in the direct speech means here, this you is in the second person, are changed in the indirect to the same person as the noun or the pronoun which comes after the introductory verb. After the introductory verb means, this is your introductory verb, that is your reported verb. We also say introductory verb. So this is the subject of the introductory, this is the subject of the introductory verb, and this is the object of the introductory verb. So here, two people are talking to each other. So Hari said to me, correct? And then you are wrong. So Hari is talking to me and he is saying you are wrong. So who is this you? It is me. It is the object of the introductory verb. So when we change it into the indirect, it will become Hari told me that I, R will become was and wrong will remain wrong. So your sentence will be Hari told me that I was wrong. Now when two are talking, right, when your introductory verb is said, that said becomes told. And this too, we do not write it again in the indirect. We omit that too in the indirect. And said will become told. Why? Because two people are talking among themselves. Okay, then the next one. Ali said to Ashok, see, again two are talking. You are a good boy. So this will change into Ali told Ashok, we don't write this too, that he was a good boy. Why he? Because Ashok is a boy. Sita said to Kamla, you are a good girl. Again, you here, second person. But here we have written she. Why? Because she is relating to Kamla, who is a girl. So in indirect we write, she, Sita told Kamla that she was a good girl. The next one, John said to him, you have not done your work. So John told him that. Him is a boy, so this you will become he. Have will become had. Not done your work will become his work. Who is this his? This is that boy, him. So here we write he and here we write his. The next one, James said to her, you have done your duty. So James told her that she had done her duty. So all these pronouns, they change according to the object of the introductory verb. So we need to change the pronouns also. Now your rule 6 is, if the pronoun of the third person in the direct speech remain the same in the indirect speech, means in the direct speech, if it is he here, which is the third person pronouns, okay, when we change that into the indirect, that he in the direct speech remains the same in the indirect. So here, Harry said to me, again two are talking, so this said becomes told. We remove the two. Harish told me that he was ill. Okay? He said to me, she was right. So here, he told me that she was right. This third person pronoun remains the same in the indirect also. So, but no change of person is made when the speech is reported to the person to whom it was first addressed. So this no change is made because this is the person only whom we are talking about. Now we need to know that in all the above examples, the verb said in the direct speech becomes told in the indirect. And the preposition to is omitted. As I said, when two are talking, we change this said into told. And this too, we do not write it in the indirect. So I hope, children, you have understood this rule of 4, 5, and 6.
So now let us begin with exercise 2. Your first question. John said, I am ill. So your indirect answer will be, John said that. He was ill. So who is this I? That is John. So we change that pronoun into he. Second, I said, I will do it. So your answer will be, I said that I would do it. I will remain I and will become would. Third, James said, I am quite well. So your answer is, James said that he was quite well. So here I we change. Why? Because it is related to James. So he is a boy, so we write he. Fourth, I said, the boy calls me bad names. So your answer is, I said that the boy called me bad names. So here calls is in the simple present, so it changes into simple past, that is called. Fifth, she said, I am very busy. So your answer will be, she said that she was very busy. So this I is related to the subject of the introductory verb. So that will be she. So I changes into she, and am is simple present, so that will change into was. The sixth one, my brother said, I have been very ill. So your answer will be, my brother said that he had been very ill. So this I is related to the subject of the introductory verb, said. So my brother, we write he. And have been, which is in present perfect, changes into the past perfect. So it becomes had been. The seventh one, his sister said, my book has been stolen. So your answer will be, his sister said that her book had been stolen. So his sister, we are talking about sister. So we write, in place of my, it becomes her. Eighth one, you said, I will not go there. So your answer will be, you said that you would not go there. It is someone else said that I will not go. So it changes, that I changes into you. Ninth, you said to me, you will go there. Now two are talking. So as I had said, that when two are talking, we remove that said and we write told, and we do not write to in the indirect. So your answer will be, you told me that you would go there. Will change into would. And we do not write to in the indirect. We omit the to when we write it into the indirect. The tenth one, you said to her, you are wrong. So your answer will be, you told her that she was wrong. So here the you was related to the object of the introductory verb, that is her. So when we change it into the indirect, that you in the direct speech becomes she in the indirect. 11th, John said to me, you are right. So your answer will be, John told me that I was right. Again, I is related to the object of the introductory verb, that is me. So that you changes into I. 12th, Satish said to Anil, you are an intelligent boy. So your answer will be, Satish told Anil that he was an intelligent boy. So who is this he? We are talking about Anil. So the direct speech you becomes he in the indirect, because we are talking about the object of the introductory verb, that is Anil. 13th one, Sita said to Bimla, you have not learnt your lesson. Your answer will be, Sita told Bimla that she had not learnt her lesson. So again we change that you into she. Why? Because we are talking about the object of the introductory verb. 14th, he said to her, you are a good girl. So your answer will be, he told her that she was a good girl. The 15th one, Kumar said to me, I have played well. So your answer will be, Kumar told me that he had played well. So now this I is talking about the subject of the introductory verb. I is in the first person. So when your reported speech is in the first person, I, it is related to the subject of the introductory verb. So that is why we change that I into he, means we are talking about Kumar. So dear children, I hope you have understood the second exercise. Now your homework is that you need to write it very neatly in your grammar notebook. So thank you and have a very nice day.